Voting is underway in 288 assembly seats across the Indian state of Maharashtra. Now, polling is also taking place for 38 seats in the second and the final phase of Jharkhand assembly elections. Votes will be counted on November 23rd. Maharashtra is witnessing a fierce battle for power between two major alliances. On the one hand is the Mahayuti alliance led by Bharatiya Janata Party. It comprises the breakaway faction of Shiv Sena led by Eknath Shinde and Ajit Pawar led NCP. On the other hand, it's the Mahavikas Agadi alliance led by Congress. Now, Uddhav Thackeray led Shiv Sena and the NCP led by Sharad Pawar are part of this alliance. Voting will conclude at 6 p.m. local time. 6.61% turnout has been recorded till 9 a.m. A total of 4,136 candidates are in the fray, which includes 2,086 independent contenders. Now, the BJP is contesting in 149 seats, Shinde's Shiv Sena on 81 and Ajit Pawar's NCP on 59. The Congress has fielded 101 candidates, Uddhav Thackeray's Shiv Sena 95, and NCP led by Sharad Pawar has fielded 86 candidates. The MVA was hit by corruption allegations on the eve of the elections, with a retired police officer accusing Sharad Pawar's daughter, Supriya Sule, and State Congress Chief Nana Patole of being involved in a fraud case involving cryptocurrency that dates back to 2018. Now, the funds he alleged have been used for campaigning in the assembly election. Sule has denied any wrongdoing and lodged a civil and criminal defamation case against Sudhanshu Trivedi, the BJP spokesperson, who held a press conference on the matter and presented audio clips which he claimed were evidence of involvement of Patole and Sule. Speaking of Jharkhand now, the JMM-led India bloc and the NDA-led by BJP is locking horns in the state. Voting for the 38 seats is underway in 14. 218 polling booths will continue till 5 p.m., barring the 31 booths where it will end at 4 p.m. 12.71% voter turnout has been recorded till 9 a.m. Now, in the first phase, 43 seats went to polls and a turnout of 64.8% was recorded. Altogether, 528 candidates, 472 men, 55 women and a third gender person are in the fray in this phase. Among the key contenders are Jharkhand Chief Minister Hemant Soren, his wife Kalpana Soren and Leader of Opposition Amar Kumar Bauri. Now, besides assembly elections in Maharashtra and Jharkhand, the Election Commission of India is also holding by-polls in 15 assembly seats across Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Kerala and Uttarakhand today. And for more on this, a special correspondent, Disha Shah, now joins us live from Mumbai. Disha, good to have you with us on the show this morning. Tell me, the voting is currently underway in Maharashtra. What is it that you're gathering from around you on the ground?
Well, certainly it is an important day for the state of Maharashtra, and voting is underway till 11 a.m. 18% of voter turnout has been recorded across Maharashtra, and we are here at one such polling center where we can see a lot of voters have stepped out to vote, including the senior citizens, and we can see amid heavy security as well to ensure that the voting process goes smooth and has no disruptions at all. So we are looking at the voting to progress through the day further as well, so that the voter turnout becomes fairly decent till the end of the poll, that is at 6 p.m. So talking about Maharashtra specifically, why these elections are important, to mention this, Maharashtra always has been known as a swing state. Why I say this? Because in the last 5 years, we have seen three different chief ministers, we have seen three governments and splits into big regional parties like the Shiv Sena and the NCP. So now there are two major alliances in Maharashtra, which is the Mahayuti, the ruling power here, and the opposition, which is the Mahavikas Agadi, and six political parties. So that becomes even more interesting to see that how these elections fare for each individual party here that we talk about. And the major contest that we are going to see is in the constituencies like Baramati, Nagpur, and even urban cities like Mumbai as well as Thane, because there are key candidates who have really gone all out to campaign on the same, to talk to the voters, to go door to door to speak about the issues. And specifically, if you talk about it, it's got direct contest to watch closely for is going to be NCP versus NCP, which is contesting in directly 36 seats. And then we talk about Mumbai, the epicenter of Shiv Sena versus Shiv Sena, where both the parties are contesting for 51 seats. So all of this is going to be very important to watch out for. And when we talk about key candidates as well, from Nagpur, we have the state's Deputy Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, who's pitted against the Congress candidate. Then we have, when we talk about Baramati, we have here the fight between the family. We have Ajit Pawar, who is contesting against his own nephew, Yugendra Pawar, who is contesting for the first time. So this also is the battle to closely watch for, because Baramati always is known as the Sharad Pawar bastion. So right. How Ajit Pawar is able to make a comeback in that region is something which is going to be extremely important. Then when we come to Mumbai, the epicenter, we are going to look at two key candidates, Aditya Thackeray pitted against Milind Deora from the Shiv Sena. So all of these candidates are going to play an important role, and further it is going to obviously have national repercussions as well when we talk about political alignments. And this time around, the battle is of course between the families, it is between the former chief ministers, it's a clash of legacies. And one side, Mahayuti, is making its to retain the power, and Mahavikas Agadi is trying to make a strong comeback.
Right. Disha, thank you for that lowdown. You very keenly pointed out how Maharashtra has always been touted as a swing state. Now, within Maharashtra, Mumbai votes slightly differently. If you've been able to speak to voters around you, what is it that they're voting on the basis of in Mumbai? And what is the sense that you get overall in Maharashtra? Which will be the key deciding factors that will drive the voters to the polls and choose the candidates of their choosing?
Well, absolutely. We have been talking to the voters through the day from 7 a.m. Today, and specifically for Mumbai, like you said, Mumbai votes very differently. They come in a little late, of course, after 11, 12 to vote, but the voting percentage always has been decent enough if you compare it with the other districts in the state. We can see even from senior citizens, they diligently come out and vote. But what issues that they really impact, especially the urban voters, is about the infrastructure. It's also about the employment. So all of these are the issues that really dominate here, especially in cities like Mumbai, in Thane, unlike the western belt of Maharashtra, which is the entire agrarian belt, where the agriculture issues dominate, like the prices, the crop insurance of soybean and all of those crops and Maratha agitation. But urban voters, they vote little differently. They want to vote for power. They want to vote for popularity. They also vote keeping in mind the urban issues, including the infrastructure development that is taking place throughout the city, from the metro projects to the new airport coming in the neighboring areas. So all of these are the issues that really dominate. And much recently, the Dharavi redevelopment as well, which has been taken by the Adani group. So that all of these issues have always been the talk of the town. And especially in the last couple of months, we have seen in the campaign, the key candidates going out all guns, door to door, talking to people about the issues, making poll promises, specifically for the women voters, who constitute 49% of the voting population. So bringing out welfare schemes for them, even MPA on the other side, the opposition, promising that what they will do for the women voters and specifically youth is something that will be closely to watch out for.
Thank you so much, Disha, for that extensive ground report from Mumbai. For all the latest news, download the VEON app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.